Great to be here. I couldn't make it last year because I was filming and I was gutted actually. So yeah, I'm really happy to be here tonight.
It's an obvious question, but what does the BAFTAs in particular amongst awards mean to you?
The BAFTAs is recognition for, you know, everybody's hard work really. I went to the BAFTA Craft Awards last year. You know, and the way that everybody's just been sort of awarded for their hard work and creating amazing drama and television and comedy and all the variations of television that we've kind of got. And yeah, it's kind of like the Oscars for TV really, isn't it? So it's a massive deal, yeah.
Talking about amazing television, that brings us very nicely to the show. I mean, what do you think it is about it that's captured audiences so much?
I just think it's Shane's bravery, really, and the actor's bravery in which we're all sort of willing to take it to an extreme level where it becomes so real and the characters become so effective, and we are a close bunch of, you know, a group of friends anyway, that we have, we're comfortable enough to do all that. It's got to be down to Shane. It's his show and it's his creative, genius-like mind that does it, so... Yeah.
It's also a spectacularly gifted cast working very well together. I mean, what's your proudest moment looking back over the series so far?
I mean, working with Johnny Harris, for me, who's a very, very close friend of mine, and I admire his work massively. So for me, working with him, he taught me a lot about making that character real, and, you know, that for me was a big deal. But there's so many scenes where I look back and... even to myself, wonder where I was, and I must have got so lost in the character that, you know, it's not an experience I've had before on another show or on another project. So it's an out-of-body experience, I guess, in some way. That's probably a bit of an odd way to put it, but, you know, she's a character I know better than anybody, and she is like a pleasure to play, as painful as it is. But
I mean, talking specifically about your character, she's a character that audiences just seem to have latched onto. Why do you think your character in particular is one that people are so interested in, so fascinated by?
I've always said there's lols out there. You know, there are characters out there and living and breathing those sort of experiences. And, you know, they're really, really difficult subjects to talk about, never mind try and act out. And I think she's, you know, we didn't hide anything. If you name everything that's gone wrong in her life and that's happened to her and the tragedies that she's been through, you kind of go, if you wrote it down, you go, does that really exist? Well, it does. And I think the fact that we were brave enough to put it out there and make it, you know, and highlight everything, I think audience just, they respond well to when you're honest with them. And, you know, they are hard enough to take those sort of subjects. I think people can maybe not see themselves in Lowell, but she's got a lot. There's a lot going on, and I think everybody can kind of go, I felt like that one day, or I've, you know, I don't know where I'm going with that now. But yeah.
Talking about going places, I think fans have been delighted to hear that there is going to be more This Is England, This Is England 90. I mean, your character's already been through so much. Where would you like to take her? Where do you think she should be going from
here? I think she should stay in, have a brew, have a load of children, and that be that. I think she will have a much easier time, whatever the storylines are. I have no idea if it's even going to happen. But I don't think there'll be an extended... I think her tale has kind of been told now, to that extent anyway. I think it's time for her and Woody to be happy and settle down. That's what I'd like to see her do. But
fans would very much like to see you happy. I think they'd also like to see you anywhere else. So have you got anything else on the go at the moment? Anything else coming up?
Yeah, I've been busy actually doing quite... I've got a few projects coming out this year. True Love for BBC and Line of Duty, which is coming out later this year on BBC Two.
Is that with Martin Compson as well? Yeah,
that's it, yeah. And I've done some feature films, did Anna Karenina. I did a small job on Hummingbird, and I've just finished filming Svengali, which is not sure when that's out, maybe next year, but yeah.
Smorgasbord of awesomeness there. We're very excited about all of...
variation, a bit of comedy, cop drama, period. It's, yeah, I've really enjoyed the variation of work that's kind of you know, come to me. So
it's definitely a variety there. I mean, can you maybe start by just Line of Duty? Can you tell us a little bit about your character on that? Because it's a little bit of a different role for you.
Yeah, it's completely different. And I'm basically playing a police officer, DC Fleming. And I can't say too much because she's quite, the character's got, it kind of comes through on the latter episodes, you know, her intention, so to speak. But she's in a very male-orientated force, and she's got a job to do, and she does it well, I hope.
You're very busy being on our screens, but tonight celebrating a lot of different types of TV. When you're not on TV, what do you like to watch?
Oh, I'm watching Breaking Bad at the minute, and I'm hooked.
What do you like about Breaking Bad so much?
Well, people kept telling me about it and going, oh, you've got to watch it. And I didn't really know much about it. And I thought, you know, sometimes you just miss. People go, where have you been, under a rock? And I'm like, well, I've obviously missed it. But I went and bought the film.
I've been busy winning BAFTAs, don't you know?
Well, I don't know. Well, I've been busy working, so that's been good. But, I started watching it the other night. And the first scene, just even when the van sort of crashes, I was like, God, that's an opening start for an amazing TV series, and I've just been hooked on that. So, but I really enjoyed Top Boy last year. I thought that was an incredible show. And you know, I watch a variation of things. I'm liking Four Rooms at the minute. I like that.
Eclectic tastes. We like.
No, but I enjoy it because it's random. You know, it's random. Loads of different things.
I mean, you mentioned obviously you are starting to do some features as well. I think Anna. I mean, would you like to do more of that? Do you see yourself going onto the big screen a bit more often?
I'd love to. I'd love to do more films. I enjoy filming films as much as I do television. There doesn't feel, apart from being on set a lot longer, there doesn't seem to be a massive difference in terms of, you know, I think TV are really upping the stakes in the way that we do things and the way that we shoot everything. And in that respect, you know, when you're actually on the job, it doesn't feel too dissimilar to film. For me, it's all about the script. So you just take what you enjoy, really. So
a lot of young fans watching this are going to love watching you. They're also going to want to emulate your success and step into your shoes. What advice would you give to them about becoming an actress and getting themselves, especially on television?
Yeah, I mean, it's hard to say, really, because everybody's journey is so varied. Some people go to drama school. I went to Colton TV Workshop in Nottingham, and, you know, there's no guarantee of you ever gaining any sort of success, and you just have to work hard. And it's all about being persistent in this game. You know, you have to take the rejection when it comes, and I still get rejected for jobs that I'd like. No matter if you've got a BAFTA or not, if you're not right for the job, then you're not right for the job, and you just have to learn to accept that. I just think if you work hard and you're willing to, you know, you just have to work hard, I think. That's all I've done.
Talking of young fans, we're huge supporters of Childline, the UK national helpline for young people going through difficult emotions or situations. Obviously, your character on the show goes through an awful lot. What advice would you give to young people about coping with difficult emotions, difficult situations?
It's hard to say, you know, not knowing what their issues are, but I think ultimately you have to talk to people and never take something on just by yourself. If something's bothering you, if you've got problems or you feel sad or lonely or whatever it might be, share it with somebody that you trust and be honest with them, and you know they will help if they can, and they will put you in the right, you know, in the right place, really. So just never suffer in silence. So
that is amazing advice, and it's been amazing to talk to you tonight. We're going to let you go and get some champers. Do you have a message for fans before you leave? Is there anything you'd like to say to them?
Thanks for all your support, really. Thank you very much for your support, and have a nice day.